Ready to race, board is on. Green light and go. Good launch there from Lynch. Good launch from Moore. No launch at all from Steve Cousins. He fails to get away from the grid and is now right in plumb last before he's even reached the first corner. So a disaster from Steve Cousins because he has been hugely impressive so far. And now for the first time today, Tony Lynch leads the field ahead of everybody else. So now Steve Cousins, we're going to see him on the recovery drive. We're going to see Terry Moore trying to attack Tony Lynch in towards the Devil's Elbow. Big old lock up there from Tony Lynch as he goes into the left-hander, manages to keep it on the straight and narrow and holds on to the race lead. But now keep an eye on the number 50 in the background of Steve Cousins, because that was a shocker of a start and he's got it all to do.
Yeah, very odd from Cousins. Sort of launched and then launched again and was delayed. And Terry Moore is really getting held up somewhat by the MR2 of Lynchy. We know that Tony hasn't got the pace of Moore and Cousins over a race distance. He always starts the races well, but does fade. So Steve Cousins in third place needs Tony Lynch to do him a favour here and hold up that little 74 red mini of Terry Moore. He's done that for a lap. He's done it for a lap and a little bit now. And Terry Moore is getting held up behind this Toyota MR2. And suddenly we have a three-car scrap for the retro final, because Tony Lynch is still leading the way. And Terry Moore is getting increasingly impatient behind the Toyota MR2, because that Citroen AX of Steve Cousins is coming well into the picture, and we're going to have three cars as one on the rise up into the North Bend hairpin.
Into the North Bend hairpin we go then. Cousins trying to take the inside line. Oh, no room there for Terry Moore on the outside as Tony Lynch is a little bit slower than him. They run side by side, the Mini versus the MR2, down in towards the paddock bend, and Terry Moore is now ahead. He puts Tony Lynch between himself and Steve Cousins. Moore and Cousins have been battling like cat and dog all over the course of here today at round one at Linden Hill. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens here, whether Lynch can try and close back that gap between them. But Cousins there in third place, you think it's only surely a matter of time before he is able to find his way past the Toyota MR2. He certainly looks the quicker of the two drivers, maybe into the Devil's Elbow. The opportunity is going to present itself. There's a bit of contact, a bit of forceful manoeuvring there from Steve Cousins as he tries to muscle his way through on Tony Lynch. He's not quite able to do so. They run side by side almost up the top of Harry Hill and into the North Bend. Lynch has got the defensive line. He's got the inside. That will compromise his run, but Cousins is out a bit wide and doesn't have the drive down the hill that needs to use it on this occasion.
Yeah, Steve Cousins would have wanted Lynchy to hold up Terry Moore. He wouldn't have wanted him to hold up himself coming into this end of the fourth lap. They've got five laps to run over, and Terry Moore will be liking this, because that Citroen AX has been locked to the rear of Steve Cousins' car throughout this opening round of the Retro Rallycross Championship. But now this Toyota MR2 of Tony Lynch has come to play, and he is really fighting for the podium spot. He won second. He's still not out of contention for the top spot, because he's really sticking with them this time, which we haven't seen in the qualification races.
Here we go then. Oh, look at this on the grass here for Steve Cousins. Tony Lynch doesn't give him any racing room at all. Can he get it slowed down for the hairpin? Yes, he can. But goodness me, that was rough and ready there from Lynch. I have to say, it moved over a little bit late for my liking. Just to remind you, by the way, if you're tuning into this and thinking to yourself, hang on a minute, why is there no Joker lap? Well, of course, these are retro cars, so we run them akin to the rules they would have faced back in the day, where there was no Joker lap in Rallycross. So nothing like that to contend with. It's just laps of exactly the same circuit, so all the overtakes have to be done out on track. And speaking of overtakes, Steve Cousins has only got one lap left to do it here. And is he going to be able to? I don't know if he will. He's certainly been quicker than Lynchy, Tony Lynch, in that Toyota MR2 in second place, but he hasn't had an opportunity to find his way past. To be fair, Lynchy hasn't given him much room, and all the while they've been doing that, it's allowed the red Mini, you can see at the top of the hill, to lead the way. Terry Moore has been absolutely commanding in this race here so far, as Tony Lynch goes to the defensive line once again. Steve Cousins tries to find his way through. Sideways there from Lynchy on the outside as they come down the bottom of the hill. He's going to go defensive surely into the paddock bend as Terry Moore comes through into the final series of corners. Very close indeed between them. Steve Cousins run out of room on the outside. No way for him to find his way through. Moore takes the win in the retro final here for round one of the Five Nations British Rallycross Championship, ahead of Tony Lynch, and Steve Cousins comes home in third place.